So, if you've ever wondered, like, how a lava lamp actually works, then I could always demonstrate it. So, I have the supplies for a homemade one. And three things about it is, in a lava lamp, there is, in an actual lava lamp, there is water, which, in that water, there's salt and antifreeze. And there's also the wax, which are the bubbles. And the wax is mixed with dry cleaning fluid, so it doesn't stick and kind of go with the water. And then to heat the wax, there's a heat light bulb underneath an actual lava lamp. And bubbles rise because it's heated. And then when they get to the top, they sink down. What you're going to need for a homemade one and why, you're going to need water for the bubbles. You're going to need a jar or a container of some sort to hold it all so you can actually make it. You're going to need vegetable oil to have the bubbles stay in their form. You're going to need, if you want, you can do food coloring to have the bubbles a different color, I guess. A funnel to keep everything in when you pour it, and Alka-Seltzer to like form the bubbles. When the Alka-Seltzer mixes and dissolves with the water, it forms bubbles, and those will rise. So then when they get to the top, it'll release the gases, and then bubbles will start floating down again. Now I'm going to show you how to do it, and after that I'll tell you a couple of facts. So first, what you're gonna do is put the funnel on. Add some water. About that much. Grab your vegetable oil. A fair amount in. Since the vegetable oil is less dense, it will float on top of the water and it will not mix. And then what you're going to want to do is take your food coloring. You don't want too much in. So maybe like 2 drops of that. And those will sink, and it'll take a little bit for them to break through the bottom and mix with the water. So the two facts, or at least a couple, are since a lava lamp, it was actually made in 1948 by a World War II fighter pilot, and he named it the Astrolabe, and later on in like the 2000s, it was called the Lava Light, and that inventor of the lava lamp actually died in, I think, 2000. He was 82 when he died. So, a while for it to mix, but when it does, you're going to want to mix it around just a little, because then it'll fully involve the water, like there. It just broke into the water. So when it does that, you're going to want to swirl it around and mix it. And so like a couple of nights ago, I did this and I only put two in, I could probably put two in again. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to grab your Oxeltzer tablets. Since this is it's a neck, what you're going to want to do is I like to break it. So. And then that'll start making bubbles that'll rise. Some of them will get bigger, some will just stay small. And when they rise, they release the gases. So if I were to like plug this up and let it do it for a while, and then we're to let it go, it puts out like air, like it builds up air. Since the gases are getting released from the bubbles. So yeah. So what we went over was what's in an actual lava lamp, why you're gonna need, what you're gonna need, and why, and how you're gonna do it, and just a couple of facts. And so next time, when you want to do, when you're bored and you kind of want to do something, you always do a experiment like this because it's pretty simple and it's cheap.